Welcome to this Saturday's Travel and History Tip. Today, we will be talking about Thomas Edison and his laboratory in West Orange, New Jersey. I do want to remind you to go to danisbooks.net, look at the different books that I have written, and to be able to view all the videos that I have made for these Saturday Travel and History Tips. Please tell a friend about our YouTube channel. We would really love to double our subscriber count this month, and we need you to help us to do that. In the Off and On the Beaten Path series, the Unclassic Road Trip, the Eastern Edition are all the states east of the Missouri and Mississippi rivers. The Central United States includes the Great Plains and all the Rocky Mountain states. And the Western United States includes the Pacific Northwest, California, Utah, Nevada, and Arizona. We will be going to the Eastern Edition today and to New Jersey, to the Edison National Historic Site. Dedicated in 1962, Edison National Historic Site includes inventor Thomas Alva Edison and his wife, Minus home. The 29-room red brick and wood mansion called Glenmont is the highlight of the 16-acre estate. Edison resided at Glenmont from 1887 until his death in 1931. He and Mina are both buried at the stunning estate. His large lab complex at West Orange is a key part of the park. Plan a travel time of at least 15 minutes between the home and the lab. We walked, which was a much simpler way. A vault was built in 1940 to house his papers and rare examples of early inventions. Years prior to living at West Orange, Edison had established his industrial research laboratory in 1869 in Newark. However, at Menlo Park, he produced his most important works at his invention factory. In his workshop, he invented the tinfoil phonograph in 1877, incandescent light bulb in 1879, the kinetoscope, a motion picture camera, and the nickel-iron alkaline battery. On October 19, 1879, his first successful light bulb began to glow and stayed aglow for 45 hours until it overheated. To prevent overheating, he and his assistants tried 6,000 kinds of organic materials before finding the winner, bamboo fiber. The bamboo gave the bulb a life of 1,000 hours. He also built the largest electric generator, which weighed 1,103 pounds, a reported efficiency of 82%. Over half of his 1,093 patents were awarded while he worked out of his invention factory. He formed Edison Light Company in 1889, which later became General Electric Company. At times, he had upward of 200 employees. In our Nuggets series that we provide each week, we are presenting a four-part series on Nikola Tesla. And Nikola Tesla was a contemporary and somewhat an adversary of Thomas Edison. And I want to encourage you to go watch Nuggets 114, 115. Next week, we will be presenting Nugget 116 and 117. In those nuggets, we mentioned that Nikola Tesla was more the inventor and Thomas Edison was more of the entrepreneurial businessman. And this sign says just that. Thomas Edison was not just an inventor, he was a businessman running an industrial empire. Around the laboratory, Edison built large factories where thousands of employees mass-produced his inventions for the public. Edison understood the importance of capital. I always invented to obtain money to go on inventing. The imposing six-story concrete structure was completed in 1914 to produce storage batteries and is the last surviving Edison factory building. The others were demolished in the 1960s and 70s. At its peak in 1918 to 1919, Thomas A. Edison, Inc. employed about 10,000 workers in West Orange. This is an aerial view from 1928, which shows the extent of Edison's West Orange factories. To quote the park brochure, come visit the laboratory complex. Explore 20,000 square feet of additional exhibit space, including two floors of the main laboratory building, which were previously closed to the public. Spend an hour or spend the day. The laboratory is now a self-guided experience. One of the most exciting things to me was walking up and down these steps in the laboratory. And as I was doing it, I said to Steve, do you realize that Thomas Edison walked up and down these very steps? What was kind of funny about that whole statement was when we walked across to one of the other laboratories, a ranger was giving a ranger-led tour, and he was going on talking about the different things in the building. And then he said, and then when you leave here, if you haven't been already, go over to the laboratory. You can walk up and down the steps that Thomas Edison walked up and down when he worked over over in the laboratory. And I was like, I just said that. And here is an elevator of sorts, identified for the use of Mr. Edison only. So I guess when he didn't want to walk the steps, he used this very basic elevator. The complex is filled with inventions. Behind this wall, in 1888, in a small room long since dismantled, Thomas Edison and W.K.L. Dixon created the first motion picture camera. In one of the featured rooms, we found phonographs. This is the first phonograph. It was invented in 1877. The first time anyone ever recorded sound and played it back was when Edison used this machine to record Mary Had a Little Lamb. It recorded sound waves as indentations on a sheet of tinfoil. And here is that first ever recording.
The first words I spoke in the original phonograph. A little piece of practical poetry. Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow, and everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go.
The National Park Service preserves approximately 28,000 disc phonograph records, 11,000 cylinder phonograph records, and 9,800 disc metal molds at Thomas Edison National Historic Park. And this is the earliest known Edison wax cylinder phonograph from 1887. After devoting several years solely to incandescent lighting, Edison returned to the development of phonographs with this model, based on new improvements from inventor Alexander Graham Bell's Volta Laboratory. This design used a wax cylinder record instead of a tinfoil record. The Park Service will loan you a headphone, and then there are codes that you can type into this, which gives narrated information of all the displays. This Stroh violin and viola, circa 1901. Because stringed instruments did not record well, inventor August Stroh designed these specifically for phonograph recording. The instrument's horns amplified the music and directed it toward the recording horn. Remember these old style cameras? You've seen them in museums, no doubt. The Thomas Edison National Historic Park Archives preserves approximately 5 million pages of original material documenting the life and work of Thomas Alva Edison, including Edison's personal and business correspondence, laboratory notebooks, legal files, patent records, engineering drawings, manufacturing and financial records, advertising and sales material, payroll records, historical photographs, trade catalogs, sheet music. Some of the 400,000 artifacts include prototypes and commercial Edison products, laboratory furnishings and equipment, and the personal items used by the Edison family at their home, Glenmont. In one section, they had display cases, bookshelves filled with items, including these bust of Edison and this doll that talks from 1890. A tiny wax cylinder phonograph inside his talking doll played a childlike voice reciting nursery rhymes, or at least it was supposed to. Over 3,000 of the toys were manufactured at the Edison Phonograph Works, and here are some adding machines, typewriters, and you can see this style of display cases they had, protecting this amazing collection. 1887 Chemistry Laboratory Building was one of the best equipped chemistry laboratories in the world. Within its walls, Thomas Edison and his chemists experimented on everything from phonograph records to rubber. Grand science chemistry, Edison once said, I like it best of all the sciences. Beginning in the late 1890s, Edison and his staff worked for more than a decade to develop a practical storage battery for electric automobiles. After thousands of experiments, they produced a nickel-iron alkaline battery by 1909. Although not practical for electric autos, Edison's durable battery was used in industry, mining, and railroad applications. And we keep mentioning batteries, which is direct current, and this is compared to Nikola Tesla and AC power, alternating current. And I do again encourage you to watch our nuggets on Nikola Tesla. And here are some pictures of Glenmont and their garage. No photographs are allowed inside the house, but it is a gorgeous structure. Inside, it's just as beautiful. But I do want to tell you something really funny about this home. It was built by a man who was a bookkeeper at a bank, and as he scammed the bank for money, he was building this mansion and filling it with beautiful furniture, exotic items, and a tremendous library. Well, when the books were examined and it was discovered what he was doing, the home was taken from him and he was placed in prison. And Thomas Alva Edison purchased this home completely filled with furniture and a library. Glenmont, home of Thomas Alva Edison, from 1886 to his death on October 18, 1931, here three children were born to him and his wife, Mina. The library over the entranceway was his thought laboratory, for which many ideas, which later took shape at the Edison Laboratory in the valley below. And here are the beautiful gardens and greenhouses. And I encourage you to go to the park site and read the biography that they have published on Thomas Edison. And sadly, they are closed because of COVID. But hopefully this will all be removed soon and you can visit these wonderful places. And I do want to state here, let's please get on our knees and pray for our president as he is suffering with COVID. We build our future. We honor our heroes, not tear down our past. President Donald J. Trump. American history. Learn it. Love it. Appreciate it. And while I'm speaking of Donald Trump, we all need to pray he has a speedy recovery to the health that we always see him exhibit. Please make sure you are registered to vote. And if you're not, register today. Thank you.